What's up guys, Luke Seapol here, and in today's video we'll be making Greek lamb gyros all from scratch. Trini style.
Travel like the narco. Got dope like Pablo. Cut dope like Pablo. Cut dope. Chop trees with the Draco. On the north got Diego. Say hasta luego. We'll be in rapid kilo. Yeah. Snub nose with potato.
For your dry spice mix, combine 2 teaspoons of oregano, thyme, tarragon, 1 teaspoon of red pepper flakes, 1.5 teaspoons of black pepper, 1 teaspoon of paprika adobo, 2 teaspoons of cumin, 1 tablespoon of brown sugar, 1.5 teaspoons of salt, and 1/2 a teaspoon of cinnamon. Massage the spices into the meat. Onto our other seasonings, add a few dashes of bitters, 2 tablespoons Worcestershire, 1 tablespoon green seasoning, 1 tablespoon olive oil, and 1 teaspoon white vinegar. Give them a good mixy mix. Now, add 1 sprig of rosemary because you forgot to add it earlier. And leave it to marinate for 4 hours or overnight in the fridge. Using 3 metal skewers and a roasting pan, stack your meat evenly so it overlays on each other. Look at that tower of goodness. I use some extra wooden skewers to keep it upright. Place in an oven preheated to 325 degrees for 2 hours. Onto our pita bread. Whisk together 1.5 cups of warm water with 2 tablespoons white sugar. Slowly stream into your yeast and mix to combine. Let it sit for 10 minutes to activate the yeast. In a large mixing bowl, combine 4 cups of flour, 4 teaspoons salt, and 2 teaspoons baking powder. Whisk 1 tablespoon olive oil with your yeast mixture. Mix until a smooth dough is formed. Grease a large bowl and let the dough proof in a warm place for 1 hour or until doubled in size. Take your chunky boy, degas him, and see how much he weighs. Cut your chunky boy up into 12 equal pieces, approximately 94 grams each. Form them into balls and let it rest for a further 15 minutes. Lightly flour your work surface and roll your not-so-chunky boy out into the best circle you can. Grease your flat top, which is set to medium-low heat with oil. Cook on one side for about 1 minute or until bubbles form on the top. Apply some more oil to the top and flip. Cook for a further 3 minutes or until it looks like mine.
Be sure to like and subscribe. Share this video with your friends and families. And comment down below if you enjoyed it. Have a nice day.
Look how soft it is. You can't have gyros without Shadow Benny sauce. So let's make some. To your blender, add 10 cilantro leaves, 1/2 cup of water, 1 tablespoon pepper sauce, 3 cloves of garlic, 1 tablespoon both olive oil and sugar, and salt and pepper to taste. Blend until smooth. For your tzatziki sauce, you'll need 1 cucumber grated, fresh mint, 1 jalapeno, lemon or lime zest, 3 garlic cloves, fresh parsley, ¾ cup sour cream or Greek yogurt, 1/2 cup mayonnaise, lemon juice, 1 tablespoon of both pickle juice and shadow banish sauce. Lastly, some salt and pepper to taste. Traditionally, gyros are made with raw onions. However, I don't care about traditionally. Caramelized onions are way superior to raw onions in most dishes. If you've never had them, then start by adding 4 tablespoons of butter to a pan on low heat, followed by your onions. Give that a little mixy mix. Now follow it up with a bit of olive oil, 1 tablespoon of sugar, and 1 teaspoon of salt. Leave covered on low heat for 30 minutes, stirring occasionally. You know what else is superior? Grilled pineapples. Let's make some. I didn't make them on the grill, but it's fine this way too. Add your pineapples to a pan and set to medium-high heat and grill on both sides for 2 minutes each. The reason we grill the pineapples is because it makes the sugars caramelize, which results in it being 10 times sweeter than it was originally.
Time to assemble. We're not talking about the Avengers. Start with a fresh pita. Lay a bed of fresh lettuce or scarlet kale, followed by your pineapple and salted tomatoes. Next, your caramelized onions. Crown with your juicy meat.
Drizzle with chatabani sauce, tzatziki, barbecue sauce, ketchup, pepper sauce. Garnished with fresh chives and cilantro. Now that you've seen my mouth-watering superior gyros, it's time for the final viewing of your eye pleasures. B-roll.